we would like to welcome everybody to the John Armstrong Wing of the Blake Library of the Martin County Library System. It's just before 10 a.m., August 24th, Saturday morning. We are waiting for himself, Professor Seth Bramson, to put on a show for us. He'll be here momentarily. In the meantime, let me show you around the Blake Library. There are 200 chairs set up. We expect to be completely full. For the traveling transportation exhibit of the Smithsonian, my friends Jerry and Richard busily setting up three display cases. The two long ones will have FEC materials, antiques, memorabilia, artifacts of all types. And the third one will be general railroad memorabilia. So, let's get the boys set up here real quick before our guests show up. And we'll show you what everything looks like as soon as they fill the cases. Cleanup work, thank you, Richard. And some great displays. It is 10:20 on Saturday morning, August the 24th, 2013. We are at the Blake Library here in Martin County. And in front of us, the display cases from Jerry and Richard.
Are you going to be able to bring any of this down to Hobe Sound?
Yes, sir.
We've got items from FEC. Badges, watches, conductor's caps, locks. The directors from 1940, all of their records. 1926, models of the original train colors. Silver and china from the dining cars. Even a kerosene lantern from the top of the Stuart Bridge. Look at this display case. Look at the pieces in here. Keys, buttons, padlocks. Give a smile, Richard. Thank you, sir. We will be ready for Professor Bramson's speech in just a moment. So stay with us. It is 10:30 a.m. We are in the Blake Library. The cameraman is here with his equipment. Professor Bramson is here. The lovely Myrna Bramson and her table with all the books. Look at all the items.
Oh my God, the 106 is fabulous.
Okay, only because
just a table full of goodies. There's still time, folks. Don't wait a minute longer. Come and join us at the Blake Library right here in Martin County. There's plenty of seats, plenty of room. Seth will be speaking right here from the front of the room. Jerry and Richard, the FECRS guys, have brought in three cabinets of display memorabilia. Take a look at this stuff. If you can't find something to tickle your fancy here, well, you've come to the wrong place. We will be ready for Seth's speech in just a few moments. So let's finish wrapping up, and let's go. And let's go meet all our friends. Stay with us.
And Mr. Perrin is brought in to run the railroad, and he says to Mr. Flagler, I don't think we should open the hotel yet. Well, Mr. Flagler says, well, why is that, Mr. Perrin? Sir, look, let's try and work something out with your friends at the Pennsylvania Railroad, with Mr. Walters. Is there anybody here from Baltimore? Anybody familiar with Baltimore, the famous Walters Art Museum? Well, the Walters
The show is over. It's 12:30. We will be on our way in just a second. The professor is still signing a couple of books. We are on our way to Hobe Sound. Stay with us.
Rockefeller's autobiography, he very clearly states, quote, the key to our success was Henry Flagler. Every Man's Magazine did a major article in 1910 on Mr. Rockefeller. And the question was put by the young reporter, Mr. Rockefeller, was the name Standard Oil your idea? He said, hell no. It was Henry Flagler who thought of it key to our success was Henry Flagler. And that appeared in that magazine in 1910.
Okay, it's 4:30. It's been a very successful day. There are still a few folks left here in the showroom. Jerry and Richard will begin putting the display cases away. Not everybody wants to leave right now. Give a smile, Jerry.
We're getting a lot of credit. We do the Cocoa Library. I wish we had...
Cases are being stripped, but we still have all these goodies out. And it's been a great day. Folks have wanted to know all about what we're showing, what we've got. It's been a wonderful day. Two programs in one day. Stuart and Hobe Sound. As I said, it's coming up on five by the time we get loaded. The last few stragglers from the second program. That's it for August the 24th, 2013.
It's been a great day on the railroad. In the lecture room, I should actually say. August the 24th, 2013. Two Seth Bramson speeches today. And a great day with my friends Jerry and Richard. And those fabulous display cases. A lot of happy people today. Met a lot of new people. Always good to see old friends also. And you know, got to be 5 o'clock and then 5:30 from loading. Everybody was tired. Nobody wanted to pack it up. If you were with us, thanks for joining us. And if you missed this show, please do not miss the next one. I'm Caboose Mikey. Thanks for joining me.